worship you, Jesus. In this sanctuary, we give you every praise, every honor, all the adoration. We magnify your name. We come before you this morning, Father. We thank you for the grace you've given us, the access you've provided us through your blood, through the sacrifice you made on the cross of Calvary. Because without that, we wouldn't be here today. And we enter the Holy of Holies this morning to worship you.
Yeah. God-fearing mothers in the house. Amen. I want two women or two people to come and talk about their moms. Men, boys, please.
Come on, boy. Come on, let's go. All the food you've been eating in college. Tell us.
Praise the Lord. It's unfortunate that my mother just traveled yesterday to Cameroon. Yeah, but when I was young, I really didn't really know what mother really meant. Until I'm old, and I can still see my mother. And I remember like 3 weeks ago, we sat on the chair. Because I'm grown, I'm married, and I have children, I have begun to understand what she went through. So my mother, I hardly have words to describe who she is. She's everything strong, courageous, persistent, above all, prayerful. I told her some things that she was like really amazed. I said, Mom, do you remember when I was going to school? How when Dad gives me money and the money is not enough. And I turn around and go into the room and you were not working, but you turn around behind the kitchen and call for me and open your wrapper and move some money and give to me to go to school. I said, Mom, I cannot forget. I said, Mom, do you remember? There is no night in our house where we grew up where we go to bed. My mother cannot tell us what we'll eat tomorrow. There was no night. Before we go to sleep, tomorrow we're going to eat this.
Oh,
some people will say no. She said, okay, what do you want? What do you want? And we talk, and then tomorrow she cooks that food for us. My mom was a very special mother. I told her some things and she started weeping. I said, there's nothing I can do for you. I don't even have money or whatever, but I want to tell you that you have been the mother of my life, the mother of an example. I remember my father lost his job. My father was, he worked with the airlines, like an assistant pilot or whatever, and so he knew just pain. My father told my mom, I can't go to the village with you guys, because I'm not a village person. I'm on the high top. So my mother left my father because there was no money, took us to the village in Moya. I saw my mother from that high estate that she was. My mother was the one who had a cook, a steward, a driver, everything in our house when I grew up. I saw my mother left that high estate, took us, seven of us, my mother has 10 children, five girls, took us to the village. My father remained in the town in Limbe. My mother would go to the farm, split firewood, that woman, in a big heap like this. After school, we go and carry and come home. She would make puff, make a crack. Today, I can do all the stuff because she taught us to cook like never. There's none of my mother's son who cannot be in the kitchen and cook. We fry puff, we make chin, everything we did. I saw a mother who can turn things around. I want to thank you for the life of my mother. God bless you all.
Thank you. Hi, church. Good morning.
Good morning, all.
I want to talk about my mom and to all the mothers that have brought me up to what I am today. I'm sure regularly I wouldn't come today, but after going through what my family just went through, I got to place value on the mother. Like before, to me it was all about my dad. Like my dad passed away. Like I loved him so much. Like my love was so much for him. But being in that theater and watching my mom, like, oh my God. But I had value. I placed a different kind of value on her on that day. And today I just want to say she's not here because she's recovering. But obviously, I love her. And I don't know. I really don't have, like, I don't have words, but I want to say she's a strong woman. Like, that's what I mean, strong. Like, you could see her fight. And even when they're tapping her, like, she was good, you could see her fight, and she was calling so many names. And she was like, when she would come up, she would be like, take me to church. And she was like, I want to go to church. It got to some point. And today I was just quiet, and when Auntie Irene came, I burst out crying. I didn't know I gathered all of that for 6 hours. It was a surgery for 6 hours. And the end after like 7 hours, they came and called me, and like, your mom is not coming. Your mom is not waking up. Can you come and talk to her? I was like, what am I supposed to say? I don't know anything about medicine. But I stood there and I saw this woman fight to come back to life. And I want to say, I thank her that she could put up that fight. I love her, like, with a love which I really cannot express, but honestly today, I appreciate her. And to every woman that has brought me up, thank God for Auntie Lola, Auntie Maggie, I thank you. Thank you, Mommy P, I don't know where she is, but she's somewhere. And Auntie Irene, thank you so much, like, you really cannot put, I cannot put a price on the fact that I saw her the first person, like, I was almost passing out, and then she came. I just burst out crying in the corridor. I want to say thank you to Dunamis, all the mothers here. You guys are strong. You show us a good example. Like, there are many mothers out there. It's like, what is it? But then when you come to church, you're grounded. Just the hug, just the advice, just something you say to someone, it resonates within that person. I want to say thank you all to all the mothers for what you do. Only God knows how you do it. God bless you all. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Good morning, church. This is good. Everyone knows I love my mom. My mom's boy. Even though my mom can yell and yell. Yeah. And even though I honor my mom all the time, but I tell my mom I love her so much. Everything I do now, I just think about my mom. I remember one day we were on the field, and then we were losing, and then my captain, he was trying to get us motivated. So he said that these last couple plays play as if the man in front of you has taken everything from mom. And I don't know, it's like some type of anger came out of me. And I never played that part in my life. So I mean, ever since then, I've just been thinking like everything I do in school, life, everything I do, I try to just try as hard as possible to do everything I can do. Just imagine that it took everything from my mom, so I'm able to provide for my mom one day. So soon, mom will be working. I'll get everything. I got you. I love you.
To call for Sister Isabel to come and lead us in a prayer for all the mothers. Amen.